Welcome back. In this section, I'm going to show you how to customize your MT5 platform. Right? What do I mean by customize? By default, you get to see these colorful charts that have got a black background with indicators loaded, right? With a whole lot of indicators on them. Now, as institutional traders, we must always adhere to clean charts that show us exactly what price action is doing without any disturbance from indicators or anything. Remember, we are price action traders. We read what price is telling us. We don't rely that much on indicators. So I'm going to show you now how to customize the platform. But before I go any further, let me show you how to insert the time frames. So you can see I don't have my time frames here on the chart. So I'm gonna go to view, then I'll go to toolbars, right? Once I'm on toolbars, then I click on time frames. Now you can see that I've got my tabs for a time frames from 1 minute all the way to monthly. Right, this is MT5. MT5 supports time frames like H2, 10 minutes, H3, H6, like 8-hour candles, 12-hour candles. MT5 supports those time frames, and I'm going to show you how to add them. Because right now it shows you the default M1, M5, up to monthly. I'm going to show you how to show the other time frames now. But firstly, let's customize the chart, right? So to customize the chart, right click on the chart, then you go to properties. When you go to properties, you are greeted by this colorful menu. We are on candlesticks, where you can change a whole lot of information. But let's jump to the color section. Now here you can choose any scheme, right? Whether you want black on white, color on white, or green on black. So I'm just going to choose black on white, right? Black on white, already you can see what that it does. It changes my background to white, right? And then my foreground to black. My foreground, it means the price points and the date at the horizontal tab, right? Grid, I'm going to change it to black, right? Bar up and bar down, for now I'm going to leave them on black. But bull candle, I'm going to change bull candle to green. You can either change green or lime. Remember, this comes down now to personal preference. Bear candle, I'm going to leave it as is. Line chart, I'm going to leave it at black. Now you see that I've got my candlesticks with bull candles represented with the green, meaning price is appreciation. Bear candle represented with a black candle, meaning price is depreciating. But you can see I've got the grid and my price, current price is gray and it's not visible. So we need to change that. We go back to properties, right? Bid price, ask price, and last price line, let's put black so that the line is visible in contrast to our background. See, remember our background is white. But now we need to get rid of the grid. Right click, then unselect grid. Remember, if you right click, guys, you are faced with more option. The platform is going to give you more option when you right click. Self-explanatory, options. So now you can clearly see I've got a clean chart, right, on my platform. I've got a clean chart. Now, right now I'm on H1. Let's say I want to go on daily, right? This is a daily. You just switch. Remember, this is default. You just switch your time frames. If you want 30 minutes, then you switch the 30-minute time frame. Up here, you can see I've got an arrow that is pointing downwards. This is to shift the chart, guys. If you want more working space to forecast, you can shift the chart left or right, right? So my advice is make sure you've got more information that you see on the chart. Make sure there's a whole lot of information that you see. Now let's go up here on the tools menu, right? I'm gonna customize this tool because there's a whole lot of things that we don't use here, right? As retail traders, there's a lot of things that we don't use. So to customize each tab, for instance, I'm gonna start with the time frames. You right click on the time frame, go to customize, right? Then you're gonna be faced with this menu here, available buttons and selected buttons. Selected buttons, it means it's already here on the menu. Available buttons is the buttons that you can add. You see, there's a whole lot of other time frames that you can add, right? Now, as price action, as positional trading, as swing traders, as day trading, guys, I would advise you to remove the 1 minute. I don't promote scalping. Yes, people get rich from scalping, but I don't promote it because it's not sustainable, right? Yes, you can be successful 4 or 5 months, but after that, it might not work. You need to learn something which is sustainable, which is going to sustain you up until 60, 70 years old. And price action on higher time frame does that. So now we're going to remove 1 minute. You select 1 minute, you remove. If you want to remove 5 minutes, you select 5 minutes, you remove. So it means our time frame is going to start on 15 minutes. Now, which other time frames can I add? For instance, maybe I need 2 hours. Then I insert 2 hours. I need 6 hours. I insert 6 hours. I need 8 hours. I insert 8 hours. 12 hours. I insert 12 hours. You can see they're not in order. So like 1 hour, then I'm going to move it up, right? 4 hours. So the proper, say 8 hours, we move it down, right? 12 hours, we move it down just before daily. 6 hours, we move it down just before 8 hours, and then we close. You can see now I've got my time frame in order. Yes, I need to move the H1 and H2, like these two here. H1, we need to move it down. 2 hours, we need to move it down. Let me close. So now you can see I've got more time frames, which help me in my price action analysis. And I can move this by coming to the, you can see I've got a dotted line there, and then I place it up here, right? So that you have a clean chart. Now I'm going to customize and remove the MetaQuotes editor, the register virtual server, and the register account. You just right click, go pause, save as picture. Yes, you can leave that as there. Maybe you'd want to share with your friends your charts, right? But the meta editor, we're gonna remove. Register virtual server, right? Symbols, we need it there. Profiles, we need it. We're gonna leave those. Bar chart, we're gonna remove. We're only gonna leave candlesticks line chart. Auto scroll, we need that. Then I'm gonna click close. Right, algo trading, we need to get rid of algo trading. We don't need that. We do our own manual trades here. Then which other one? Right, I would say the rest you can leave as is, right? So this is how you customize your platform, right? So that you have a clean chart where you're going to see exactly what price action is doing. You don't want to zoom out or zoom into a chart and you don't see what the candlesticks are saying. Remember, the candlestick, they tell a story. So this is how you customize the platform. So in the next lesson, I'm going to show you how to create your profiles for assets. I'll see you in the next class. Thank you.